Hey, so welcome back, friends. Today I want to give you a close-up of the new toolbox that we built in last week's video, and then I want to share with you all the tools that I have in it. Last week's video was running a little bit long, so I didn't have a chance to really give you a close-up tour of the new toolbox. But as you can see, we use the dovetail joints on all the corners. I believe this was the first one that I did, and then the second joint, and then the third side, and also the fourth. Overall, I'd say the dovetails turned out pretty good considering this was my first project where I actually, you know, used the dovetails for the joinery process. The middle divider was rabbeted into the sides of the toolbox, and then there's also another divider in the middle there that gives two compartments on one side. I think probably the favorite part of the project for me was the handle. That's a solid walnut handle. The walnut actually came from a tree that fell in on our property a couple years ago and has been drying out back. If you hear a lot of crackling during the video today, it's because I put a little bit of dried cedar in the fire this morning, and man, it is really popping a lot. I brought Arrow with me for the video today as well. So let's go ahead and start taking a look at some of these tools that I've been collecting for this timber frame project. If you're new, I'm in the process of, I'm in preparations to build a timber frame cabin. And the first step for me was to collect all the hand tools that I'm gonna need for the project. And then I built this toolbox to carry all those tools around with. So the first tool, and this tool I actually bought, I think right at 5 years ago, and this is the 30-ounce Wood is Good mallet. And this mallet is really nice. It's been a really nice addition to the shop, even though I don't use it that often because it's so heavy. I can tell you that when I built the timber frame sawhorses, I used it almost exclusively for that project, and it worked really well, but I'm quite sure that I developed some tendonitis in my right elbow from, you know, from hitting the chisel with this mallet. It is quite heavy, but the wood is good mallets are really nice. I use a smaller version for most of the other woodworking projects in the shop. If you want to skip around a little bit, I'm going to put in the description the times in the video for each tool. That way, if you want to look through the description, you can kind of skip around a little bit and you can go and hear me talk about each tool that's in here if you want to do that. And then I'll also put links to the tools in here that are new that you can purchase. Some of the tools in here are vintage, ones I've either restored or planned to restore, and I don't have links for those, of course. The second tool that I have in my toolbox is the Stanley Fatmax 25-foot tape measure. Most of the timbers that I'll be using for this project will be probably in the range of 13 to 16 foot in length. So the 25 foot tape measure should be suffice for that. I've had this for a while. I bought it in anticipation for a timber frame project. I've been using it a lot in the shop, but it's gonna primarily be used for that. And it is important for a project like this to have one tape measure and to use the same tape measure throughout the process, because some of these things can vary a little bit, and we want consistency through the joints. The next tool is the Starrett 12-inch combination square. This is a relatively new tool to me. I purchased it partially in preparation for the timber frame project, but also as having a way for a reference here in the shop when I'm doing hand planing. From what I can tell from studying you know, different brands, is the Starrett has really good tolerances and is probably one of the best on the market. This is an expensive tool, but it's also a really, really quality tool, and it's gonna get a ton of use throughout both my shop and on this timber frame project. I have some Sharpie marking pins, and these will be used for marking the ends of the timbers so I can keep up with which timber it is, which joint it is. That way things don't get mixed up as I start you know, cutting all that joinery on the timbers. I have the Lansky sharpening puck, and I'll use that for sharpening my hatchet. I do have a good set of carpenter's pencils in the toolbox for marking out the joinery. The next tool that I have is an angle gauge. This is actually a Stanley, and it is a 8-inch angle gauge. and it's a vintage tool. I'm sure you can buy new ones, but this one was given to me from a family member, and I'll use it a lot for cutting those joints. This is a 72 inch foldable ruler that's also vintage and was given to me from a family member, and I'll keep that in the toolbox and use that for laying out joinery as well. Next up is the Stanley number 10. And this is probably one of the only planes that I'll keep with me for the timber frame project. And the neat thing about this plane, I think it's actually referred to as a carriage plane, but the neat thing about this plane is that I'll be able to use it for cutting those tenons and getting up close to the shoulders. As you know, with like a Stanley number 4, number 5, you can't get all the way up to the shoulder of a joint because of the way the sole of the plane is made. But this plane, the blade or the iron goes all the way to the edge. So when you're planing, you can get right up against that shoulder and really clean up that joint really nicely. So this is a newer tool for me. I bought it off eBay and I plan to restore it soon. It's in great, great condition. It doesn't really need that much. It just primarily needs a little bit of oil and it needs the iron to be sharpened. So I'll be doing that here on the channel and setting it up, and we'll be using this a lot for cleaning up those tenons on the timber frame. So next up is the Husqvarna hatchet. I've showed you this before. It's a great hatchet, and I use it for cutting kindling, but it'll also be really nice for sort of hacking out those all that waste on those tenons and some of the mortises and things. So I'm gonna keep this sharp and keep it in the toolbox and use it when I can for the timber frame project. Probably my most favorite tool that I own, honestly, is this Barr inch and a half chisel. And this is a timber frame or framing chisel. It is made, I believe, in Idaho by the Barr company. These are hand forged tools. It was one of the first, it was actually probably the first timber framing tool that I bought, I think back in 2014 or 15. And it's got a really nice oak handle. The handle is still original to the tool. I haven't had to replace it. And it also came with a really nice leather sheath. But I'm in the process of making a holster for this tool. And this is probably the tool I'll keep on me most of the time and probably the tool that I'll get the most use. I think the majority of the mortise on this timber frame is 2 inches, but still having a inch and a half chisel will be really nice to get into those joint or into those mortises and clean them up. So I may eventually purchase a 2-inch chisel. I haven't decided yet, but this has really been one of my favorite tools in the shop so far, and it's gonna stay with me throughout this project. The next chisel in the toolbox is this vintage corner chisel. It's a 3/4-inch chisel, meaning there's 3/4 inches on both sides of the corner chisel. This is a tool that I restored last year. I made a new oak handle for it. I restored the steel and then sharpened the iron, and then I made the corner chisel sheath as well. There's a video playlist on the channel where I did that, and I'll put a link to it here in the video for you. This tool will be really, really nice for getting into those mortises and cleaning up the corners of the mortise. That's always one of the hardest things to get to, really, with any mortise, is those corners. The next tool in the toolbox is this Barr timber framing slick. And I don't know how much justice the video does for it, but this is a big, big tool. I haven't used it a ton, with the exception of building the timber frame sawhorses, because it's so big. The iron or the blade on the end of this slick actually measures, let's see, it measures 2.5 inches. Essentially the edge of this chisel or this slick is 2.5 inches in width. It's a pretty hard tool to sharpen because of its size, but it's still razor sharp from when I bought it. I haven't used it really enough to even dull it at all. It also has a removable handle. This is not a tool that you actually hit with a mallet. This is a tool that you push. It's essentially a hand plane, and you can put a hand on the iron and a hand on the handle, and you can really push and clean up those tenons rapidly with it. So It's gonna be fun to really learn to use this tool. It also has a really nice leather sheath with it as well. And I won't be making a holster for this one. It's too big and it's too heavy to wear around, but it will be in my timber framing toolbox, and I'm sure it's gonna get a ton of use. The next tool in the toolbox is a Japanese saw. The company that makes this one is, I'm sure I'm not gonna get it right, but it's a Gyokucho, and this is the razor saw. It's a really big Japanese saw. It's got two blades, one on each side, one of which is for cross cutting and one of which is for cutting with the grain. But this is gonna be super nice to clean up or to cut through the timbers that are too large for my circular saw. The blade on the Japanese chisels are also replaceable. And then the last tool in the toolbox is this framing square. I believe this was my dad's framing square. I've had it forever. I've used it in the shop almost daily. This is just about every project that I've done here in the shop. I've used this as really the reference, but it fits pretty much perfectly here in the timber frame toolbox. The cool thing about a framing square is this end is an inch and a half, and this end is 2 inches. So you can actually fit it into those mortises and test your mortises without having to, you know, move a huge timber to place it into the mortise or to fit that tin into the mortise. So this is a good reference to make sure all the mortises are the correct width. So this is primarily the tools that I have so far, at least the hand tools that I have so far. There's certainly quite a few power tools that I'm gonna need to acquire, and I have some of them already. If you'd like to see a video on the power tools that I'll be using for the timber frame, I'll be happy to make that video as well. As I said before, I'm gonna put each one of the tools that are new, at least, in the description with links, affiliate links, and then I'll also put in the video description the time that I've discussed each one of these tools. The next video you'll see from me will be the holster for this inch and a half timber framing chisel. I'm almost done with it. I think I may be able to finish it up today here in the shop and hopefully get that video out to you next week. So if you missed the video for the timber frame toolbox, I'm gonna put a link at the end for that video. That was a huge project for me. I spent 2.5 weeks building the toolbox and probably 3 or 4 days editing the video. The video itself actually had, I think it had somewhere like 400 clips in it. So it was quite the bear to edit. I'm really proud of the project and I'm really proud of the video. I'd be lying if I said I wasn't disappointed a little bit in the results of the video. It wasn't watched by as many people as I was hoping it would be. I think primarily because it's 16 minutes in length, but it's one of those videos where you get yourself a cup of coffee and you put your recliner, you lay your recliner back and just kind of sit back and enjoy it. It's not one of those videos where you're going to just get, you know, tons of education. It's going to be one of those where it's just sort of relaxing and you can just kind of enjoy listening to the tools and some good music. So anyways, if you haven't seen that video, I encourage you to watch that one. And next week you'll see the new holster that I'm making out of leather. So thanks again for watching, and I'll see you on the next video.